Hi, I'm Dr. Camilla Pang, or Millie, and I'm a scientist by day and a writer by night. So for my day job, I'm a postdoctoral scientist for a pharmaceutical company working in bioinformatics, where I deal with like clinical data to try and make sense of it to help the experimentalists come up with lead therapeutics. And I really enjoy it. Actually, it's a very good learning environment. The people are very supportive. I think it's very, very fortunate, and it's important to note that that does exist. So yeah, I deal with like I code, I work with AI, clinical data. So yeah, it's all good. In terms of my writing career, that happened by, I wouldn't say accident, but it was something that I wasn't conscious of. I think that's very important because there's lots of things that people plan, but actually, this unplanned career had just come to light because I really enjoyed writing. And I've actually recently published a book called Explaining Humans by Penguin Random House, and it's about understanding humans using science, because I actually find humans very confusing, much like every other human on this planet. But unlike every other human on this planet, I feel alien and have done since I was about 4 to 5 years old. But that's because I'm autistic. So I have Asperger's syndrome, also referred to as high functional autism. The nomenclature is a bit iffy, but that for now, let's just leave it at that. But I also have ADHD and generalized anxiety disorder. And it's interesting actually, because I wake up and I never know what I'm gonna get. I'm not saying I could be in hysterics or I could be this. It's more about, how am I gonna feel today? How is my process going to be affected today? What do I need? And I think that's actually very important to differentiate between waking up with someone who's very manic versus someone who's not motivated. And you can have both of those in one day with ADHD. So yeah, it definitely mixes life up, and it kind of forces me to think differently and have to adapt to every little routine. And as much as that's kind of painstakingly annoying, it also helps with my science, because I have to think differently, I have to focus, I have to consider what the problem is in a 360. So actually it helps me develop insight into my work and naturally be creative. I think it's really important to note that you need to be transparent with your work environment, your boss or your teammates, about knowing what you need. And that's easier said than done, because some of the things that I find hard on the autistic spectrum is knowing what I need. But I know what my shape is, and I know what I find hard, I know what I find easy, and also why. And I think by having that awareness of yourself, you will help inform other people and be like, this is what I need, this is why. You just have to be transparent with them and not leave them and be like, oh, where's Millie gone? She's done a runner, which I haven't done. Lunchtime walks don't count. But yeah, I think to have special needs in STEM is something that can be painful at first, because you feel behind, you feel like you don't fit in anywhere. But actually, science needs difference and mutual connectivity and empowerment to evolve, and that comes from a place of difference and displacement. So if you fall behind, then actually it can help you keep your head afloat, because then you always know what isn't done. And as much as that can feel like anxiety, it's actually what science needs. We need to fill in the gaps, and more of the same doesn't get you anywhere. So, YOLO.